In this video, I am using Hunyuan Video 1.5 to generate a video using an image. The model is small in size and should work on NVIDIA's 8GB card as well. The prompts used to generate video will be given in the workflow, and the images will be shared on Discord. On my 4060 Ti 16GB, processing one step took 33 seconds, and the total time for 121 frames. Took 253 seconds. So the generation is fast, hence I preferred a 24fps video instead of 16fps by one video model. On a smaller graphics card, you can begin with a small test like I did here. 48 frames took 89 seconds. I then attempted a Pixar character, and the resulting video was smooth. All video results presented here are from my first attempt. I added a simple upscaler and frame interpolation node to enhance the result. This is a simple ESRGAN model, which should work on any graphic card. And the final result is a 1024 by 640 pixel resolution. It looks really smooth at 32 frames a second. The workflow is simple, and the red color nodes requires file, which you need to download. Links will be given here. I will be adding the direct download links to make it easier. This lower section is just for testing. I wanted to control the video by uploading multiple frames. So the prompt goes to the positive and negative connection in this Hunyuan image to video node. And make sure to update the comfyUI using the update batch file because this node was added recently. The VAE is used here to encode the pixel image for the latent space. And then the image. It looks like the image we upload also takes some patch, hence there is one more connection of clip vision. The image we upload here is resized, as we always do. And this is the given size I wanted. The output image in a preview is visible on the right. The way you can use this is upload the image, bypass these nodes, and then run the workflow. The preview shows an image with resolution 349 by 512. The resolution I typed here is 512 if I make this 612 and run the workflow. The image becomes 416 by 612. So this means the image after resize will be around 612 pixels. The 612 can either be height or the width, whichever is longer, but the size will be locked at 612. I am using a 480-pixel model, so once I get my image around the same resolution, I will activate these nodes. Give the prompt and run the workflow. The prompt used can be shared with the workflow. However, I cannot share the image on Google because I got a warning email a few weeks back for sharing a Python code in some images. I was not able to understand what wrong I did, but I stopped sharing using Google Drive since then. You can get the images from Discord. I do not think there are any restrictions as such. I will make a separate video on upscale. This upscale method is very basic. One step is taking around 22 seconds, and the total time taken was 254 seconds. The result looks good. The best part is I do not have to attempt again for a simple motion video. Let's look at the files used in this workflow. This link should take us on the page where you can find all the files required. First is clip vision, but let me start with the diffusion models. So these are the image to video model. This is for 480p videos, and these are for 720p videos. In the center, these are the 480p text-to-video models. And at the bottom, there is a 720p text-to-video model. This is a FP16 model, which is large in size, and I don't know about this 1080p model. Even if I manage this model on my 16GB card, processing this many pixels will take more than an hour. You will need a flagship graphic card for this. I am using this FP8 model, but if you have a bigger card, then you can get this FP16 model. Similarly, if you want to generate a 720p video, then get this FP8 model. It should work on a smaller card. The only difference is this model can generate 720p video. And generating that many pixels on a smaller card, which is also slow, will take a lot of time to output a result. So this should take you to the page where you should find all the models, and below are the direct download links to the 480p and 720p models. Place the files in the Diffusion Models folder, and select the file in the Load Diffusion Model node. The second is the Dual Clip Loader, and both the files can be downloaded from the given links. Place the files in the Text Encoder folder, and select them here. Make sure this Hunyuan Video 1.5 is selected here. Clip Vision file can be downloaded from this link. Save the file inside the Clip Vision folder, and select the same in this Load Clip Vision node. Last is the VAE, place it in the VAE folder, and select in this node. That's all with the files. The generation time taken was 167 seconds, and the results are not disfigured or bad even at the first attempt. I really like the result generated using this model. I will try using the 720p model. Place it inside Diffusion Model folder. Press the letter R to refresh the model list, and select the model. Upload the image. Let's try the disaster girl. Update the prompt. I will keep the size at 720p and bypass these nodes to see the resized image. The resized image is fine for my graphic card. I will run the workflow. It took 45 seconds for one step, and 364 seconds to generate 121 frames, which gives me a 24 FPS video. And the quality looks good. The prompt was followed, and the result is good. So, that is the workflow. I tried using the first and last frame here, but it did not work. This was generated using the 480p model, and the result looks good. But can this model generate a 24 FPS 10-second video? I have increased the frame count from 121 to 241. Let's check what happens. Previously, it took 40 seconds for one step, and now it took 121 seconds for one step. And the VAE is still working on those 200 frames. Time taken was easily about 10 seconds on my 4060 Ti 16GB. My card has the VRAM, but it is slow. A 4070 with 16GB memory should perform better. So it took 14 minutes to generate a 24 FPS 10-second clip, and the video looks great. A few frames at the end were bad, though. The hand vanished here, but this could be the last 15 frames or so. I tried text-to-video generation by giving an empty latent video of 512 pixels. And I think I should bypass this node because I do not want the image to be a condition in this video generation. I selected the text-to-video model, and then I queued the workflow. I tried twice, but there is no progress visible in the program's output. So, I canceled the generation. I will stop the recording and complete the video here. If the text-to-video works, I will add the workflow. So, that is it in this video. I hope you have an excellent day.